So Godot 3 gets a new version, and while we all have our eyes on Godot 4, this update is kinda sick. The first thing that I would have not expected is that we get asynchronous shader compilation. So basically what happened before, whenever you used any shader material or particle material, was that the GPU first did absolutely nothing with the shader. It just let it sit there, procrastinating about. But then, when the shader was needed, it flipped out, because it needed to compile the whole thing, and that often made a lag spike the first time, for every particle material and shader. That is often. So now,
the Uber shader
comes into play. Being an
Uber shader,
it has all the power of your shaders, and until the real shader is compiled, the
Uber shader
does all the work. Then there is navigation, which no one really used because it was kinda bad a lot of the time. And now we get a backport from the much cooler navigation server from Godot 4 that even has obstacle avoidance. These backports might seem unexciting for some, but keep in mind, Godot 4 will still take a while and will miss some features. And we do not know how stable it will be in version 4.0. So for the time in between and projects close to finishing, this is huge. Another nice thing is the fix for physics jitter. Since physics and the rendering use different frame rates, sometimes one updates more often than the other. This could result in strange jittering up until now. In 3.5, it is fixed by interpolating the results of the physics calculations. Currently it is implemented for 3D, but it will be coming for 2D as well. There's even more work on 3D. We already got portal-based occlusion culling, which is a comparatively simple form that requires some setup for each scene. Now there's also the occluder shape polygon 3D, which you can place anywhere in your scene. Everything behind it can get occlusion culled because the engine knows no one can see it. This is a much more flexible tool than the portals, especially for outside regions.
And there are more nice things. We got a gradient texture 2D backport. This is really cool to color texture racks or to use in shaders. Radial gradients just look so pretty. You can now deep compare arrays and dictionaries with the new global space function deep equal. A canvas layer now has visibility. Buttons now have options on how to align the icon. And there are shader improvements, which just makes me happy. The auto completion now works for constants, the shader types. Uniform hints and incorrect suggestions were removed. This makes my life quite a bit easier because I like to write shaders. Then there's the truly most important thing. OS now has a crash function, so you can crash your game. This is intended to help test the system crash handler, as if I wasn't capable of crashing the game myself. We have some really cool backports by Rafael Pika. Particle animation speed now works well with random lifetime, and you can now use a gradient to sample a random initial color for particles, which is crazy useful. This guy also makes great content on YouTube and has just released a game. Check out Beat Invaders. There's now a time singleton that keeps some of the existing time-related functions and added some new ones for convenience. We now have a fill rect method for images. You can now set which specific auto tile you want when you programmatically set a tile. You can constrain the find and replace of strings in your scripts to folders now. Really handy. There are more small changes as you can see. We'll need some time to explore them all. If you want to help get a stable version of Godot 3.5 out quickly, you can test the beta right now and give the devs feedback. You can even try it online. We have all the links in the description. So are you excited about a new version? Let us know in the comments.